This morning we've come to Wai-O-Tapu Geothermal Wonderland, which, as the name suggests, it's got so much geothermal activity going on. One of the main attractions is Lady Knox Geyser, which is behind me, which erupts at 10:15 on the dot every single day. It is helped along by the people here. They use something to put in there so it goes off at the same time. But one thing to note is that it's a really long walk from the main center, and you have to drive to get up here. So if you do get here wanting to get to see this at 10:15, make sure that you arrive in plenty of time to get your tickets, your stamps, and then you're going to drive all the way up, or you can do a nice walk up the road. And it's cool, it's like a little amphitheater with lots of people sitting around, and they do a talk before, which we'll see shortly.
If you want to get a front row seat in the amphitheater to see the geyser go off, we recommend getting here early. We got here at 10 and there was already loads of people here, and it goes off at 10:15. I think the back is a great place to be, but if you do want to be by the front, get here early.
You're making your own volcano. You're making your own volcano. That is so cool, Bubby.
Make volcanoes to Lake Bubby.
So the site where the geyser is, just behind it, there is a huge forest. It's actually the largest forest in New Zealand and the third largest in the world. And this was cleared by prisoners who were in a prison camp just behind us somewhere. And at the end of the day, when the prisoners had been working, clearing this forest all day, they would go and bathe in this hot spring that they found. And when they were bathing in the hot spring, cleaning their bodies, cleaning their clothes, the soap broke the surface tension in the hot spring and made this huge eruption go up. And it just bubbled, bubbled, bubbled. And then it shot up into the sky like 10, 20 feet. And you can imagine they would have just been so surprised, had no idea what was going on. And that's what we know now as Lady Knox Geyser.
Lady Knox Constantine Geyser.
And if you do come here to watch it, just an FYI, we got here nice and early to get a spot. The talk didn't actually start until after 4:15, and it didn't finish until about 10:20, 10:25, and then it took a few minutes after that for the geyser to go off, so I'd say it actually went off around 10:30. So if you are running late, you might still have a hope of seeing it if you get here after 4:15.
But make sure you're here on time.
If you do come here with a child that's in a pram, they have labelled the track as being pram friendly on the map, but it is quite rocky and it is a bit uphill, and if you have a pram like ours, which is a really small wheel travel pram, it could be a little bit hard to push. So just bear that in mind if you are coming with a pram. Despite it saying it's pram friendly, it's not a paved track.
Cool, eh?
The mud pool behind me gets up to 50 degrees Celsius, which is crazy hot, and it actually has a crude oil on the top that they used to skim off and use as like a kerosene for lighting lanterns and cooking and things like that. So these geothermal pools, which we're now coming to enjoy as tourists, have had so many uses over the years and really provided a lot for the people who live in this area.
So the craters that we're walking past are eroded from the acidic elements in the steam which rise up from the waterways underneath the ground, which is really interesting, and it means that there's loads of these around this area because it's all geothermal activity around here. Some of these craters are absolutely massive, and the most recent one, which was formed, was in 1967. Pretty incredible. So the colours that you can see on the ground, purple being manganese oxide, the red and brown being iron oxide, yellow being sulfur. So it gives this incredible colourful, like rainbow-like texture to the ground, which is just super incredible, really beautiful.
The area that we're in right now is one of the most active volcanic areas in the world, and there are 17 different volcanic fields in this specific region, and two of these contribute to 5% of all the energy produced in New Zealand, which is pretty amazing.
This is the Champagne Pools.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the most famous part of the walk, and it's really interesting. It looks like what you would envisage the moon looking like. So behind Renata, it's like this kind of grey ground, which looks like any movie you've ever seen with the craters of the moon. It's super cool. And then you've got this like really amazing got this amazing green backdrop from the forest behind. So like the colors are just so beautiful.
This is also the most famous section that you might have seen if you've seen any photos of orange and beautiful blue overlapping in the pools. The water from the champagne pool is overflowing into this big one behind me, and so the water is constantly changing and the minerals are coming to the surface. And so every single day when you come here, because of the steam and the evaporation and the change in the temperature, it's always going to look completely different and be completely different colors. It's so special.
What is it?
Fart.
Is it like farts?
So we asked what Gaia thought it smelled of here, and she said farts, which is basically the sulfur, which is all around the whole area of Rotorua, which means it does smell a little bit like rotten eggs or farts, or not particularly the nicest smell in the world, but it's super unique to this area and something that you'll always remember. And it's one of those things that even just a smell can take you back to Rotorua.
The champagne pool behind me is actually the largest hot spring here in New Zealand, which is pretty amazing to be able to see it. And as I mentioned before, it changes every day because of the steam and the evaporation, and new minerals are always coming to the surface. So no 2 days that you come here will ever look the same, and it is really iconic with that bright, bright orange and the really, really blue waters, and it's so clear. It's just absolutely incredible. Words really can't do it justice.
And the reason they call it the champagne pool is because of the carbon dioxide which is released from under the water, which then bubbles like you would see in a glass of champagne. And I imagine somebody who was pretty rich named it, because not everyone knows what champagne is. The swallows, starlings and miners nest in the holes in these craters, and the heat that rises up helped to incubate the eggs, which literally blew my mind, because how clever are animals that they know that that would help to incubate the eggs? Like, literally mind blown.
The pool behind me is absolutely amazing. It is the most bright green, like a lime green colour, and it's overflow excess water from the champagne pool we were at just before, and all the minerals get suspended in here, and then the sunlight refracts the particles and it creates this amazing colour that changes every day. And Josh's favourite fact about this pool is that the pH of the water is 2, which makes it super, super, super acidic. If you come here on a sunny day like today, it's going to be this really bright, luminous green. But if you come on an overcast, cloudy day, the colour of the water will change and vary. So we are super lucky to be seeing it like this. We have just finished up here at Wai-O-Tapu, and it was so cool. I highly, highly recommend. It was $32.50 for an adult, $11 for an over 5, and under 5s are obviously free, like this one. We're now just having a quick ice cream break to refuel and power us through for our next activity, and then we're gonna head off. Hope you guys enjoyed coming with us for that first part of our day. I'm standing on the side of a dirt road right now, so don't mind the dust, but we have just been to Kerosene Creek, which is a little secret spot we were recommended. We found it on Google Maps and it was amazing. We'll chuck some footage over the top so you guys can see how cool it was, but it was so hot. It was like a thermal pool river. The rapids were really fast. It was a little bit dangerous in some spots, but we found some really calm, nice spots to swim in with Gaia. We had such a nice time, and there's a waterfall, and it was just so special. And it was free, and we were surrounded by the most beautiful New Zealand bush. It was just such a perfect end to our time here in Rotorua.
We have just got to Matamata to see Renata's cousin, who we're staying with for the night, and we've had an amazing day exploring Rotorua, Wai-O-Tapu, and the Kerosene Falls. And now we're just gonna have a relaxing night. She's got the spa pool sorted for us, and she's now cooking us dinner. So what an end to a day.
Luxury. Yeah, we had the most epic time exploring Rotorua, and we definitely only tip of the iceberg in terms of exploring there. There's so much more we could have done and wanted to do, and we'll definitely have to be back, but we're so pumped for more rooftop adventures now after our first camping trip and our rooftop tent.
Yeah, and we've got another trip planned pretty soon in a couple of weeks. So thanks again for subscribing, for following along on our trip. It's been really awesome having everybody like, comment, share, etc. So
if you do enjoy our videos, please do leave us a comment, because they mean so much to us every time we get one. So thank you guys so much, and we'll see you next week.
All right, laters, bye. So cool, enjoy this with us. So yeah, come along for a
So the site where Lady Knox Gaia is, was actually...
Geyser.
Geyser, what did I say?
Gaia.
Hot spring. Everyone's watching me. Bathing in the hot spring. What would happen is...
Bathing in the hot spring.
Yeah, they would wash their bodies. Mm. Bathing in the hot... And... And it was named after who? The first Governor General? No, the prison ward. We don't know. And it was named after the daughter of the Governor General, Lady Constantine Knox. Constance. And it was named after someone famous. The area that we're in right now is one of the most and there are 17 geothermal. This section is also the most 3450 for an adult, 11